Welcome to the Practice Norwegian podcast and episode 14 of the Basic Grammar series. So today we're going to talk about the biggest topic of the A2 level of the grammar, of the second half of the beginner's level, which is subclauses. So this is it's a topic with, so the rules are not that complicated and they are consistent, but it takes a while to get used to it. So overall, when you have a subclause, if you have a subjunction like if and that and because, they create a subclause in the normal sentence, the full sentence. In Norwegian, you call it leddsetning, like a part sentence. So subclause. So, and the thing to note here is that the word order changes a little bit if you have a subclause compared to a normal sentence. And even more short is just you change the place of the verb and the adverb. But we will show you with examples. If you start with a simple sentence, det sol, there is sunshine. And then if you want to say, de inne fordi det sol, they are inside because there is sunshine. Fordi det sol, this follows the normal sentence structure. Det sol, verb on the second place, and that's it. So if you don't have any adverbs, you don't have to think about subclauses at all. It's just if you have an adverb, you have to think about the word order. So if you have, for example, then, det ikke regn, there is no rain. And then if you want to say, hun sykler hvis det ikke regn, so she will be bicycling if there is no rain. So in this case, you have the subclause, hvis det ikke regn. So now the adverb is before the verb. In the normal sentence, you would say, det ikke regn, there's no rain. Verb on the second, adverb afterwards, det ikke regn. In a subclause, it's different. You say, hvis det ikke regn, so you put the adverb before. And then another example, de skal ikke trene, they shall not exercise, or they're not going to exercise. De kommer hvis de ikke skal trene, so they will be coming if they are not exercising. So here you have the same with the subclause, that the adverb comes before. Hvis de ikke skal trene. So there are two ways of remembering this. One is that if you have a subjunction, you change the place with the verb and the adverb. Another way of looking at this is that you have four places, and you can always just count 1, 2, 3, 4. The first is the subjunction, like this. Then you get the subject, usually just a person. Then the third is the adverb, and then the fourth is the verb. So every time if you see a subjunction, you can just stop and then you can think 1, 2, 3, 4. So this, de, like the person, number two, number three, adverb, ikke, and then the verb or the verbs, skal trene. Or the other one we had, fordi det ikke regn, so fordi, number one, number two, subject, det, fordi det, three, adverb, ikke, and then the verb, fordi det ikke and then the rest, regn. Okay, so now we have some examples you can try. So it starts with Marco sier, so Marco says, and then the words to jumble or put into the right place is han and sykler and aldri and that. So he and bicycles and never and that. So you have to put those four words into the right order. So if you say Marco sier, and then first is the subjunction at. Second, if you remember all the words now, like han and sykler and aldri. So out of those, you would say at, and then the subject, han, at han, and then you put the adverb, number three, aldri, and then sykler, number four. At han aldri sykler. Marco sier at han aldri sykler. And that is the essence of the whole word order and the subjunction and the subclause. So next one, Guri gråter, Guri is crying. And the words now, four words is hun and falt and plutselig and fordi, like she and fell and suddenly and because. So if you have those four words, you start with the subjunction, fordi, then you put the person, hun, then the adverb, plutselig, and then the verb, falt. So you can also think that the verb is quite far out there in a subclause. Guri gråter fordi hun plutselig falt. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, next sentence, Geir smiler. So Geir is smiling. Hvis han, so the words are, hvis and han and jobb and på and ikke and må. So here you have six words to jumble in the subclause. So han and må and ikke and på and jobb and hvis. So you just start with hvis, number one, hvis, then the person, han, then the adverb, ikke, and then the verb, må, på, jobb. Hvis han ikke må, that's the four places, på jobb. So Geir smiler hvis han ikke må på jobb. And then, next one, Britt drar på ferie, Britt goes on vacation, and the words are, hun syk, ikke, and hvis. So if you just look at those in the subclause, you start with the subjunction, hvis, then the person, hun, hvis hun, adverb, ikke, and then the verb, hvis hun ikke syk. So the full sentence is then, Britt drar på ferie hvis hun ikke syk. She goes on holidays if she's not sick. And then, barna sier, and the words are de, and sultne, and alltid, and at. So they, hungry, is always that. So then you start with, again, just the four places. First the subjunction, at. At is a very small subjunction. It's easy to forget that at is there, and then you get a subclause, because the word that, it's not implying that you're saying a big because or a big if, it's just like a that. So, but at, and then the person, de, so the subject or person, de, at, de, then the adverb, alltid, and then the verb, at, de, alltid, sultne. Barna sier at de alltid sultne. And the last one, butikken stenger, the store or the shop is closing, and then the words are det and kunder, ikke, fordi. So, it and is and customers and not and because. So, the same again, subjunction is fordi, person is, or subject in this case, det, and then the adverb, ikke, and then the verb, fordi det ikke kunder. So, kunder, you can say that's the people, but they are not the subject in the sentence. You say that's fordi det ikke kunder, because there is no customers. Butikken stenger fordi det ikke kunder. Good. So, that's the whole thing with subjunctions and subclauses in Norwegian. Just have to remember that you switch places with adverbs and the verbs, or you can think of the four places and then just go through them every time you see a subjunction. And also, if there's no adverb, there is nothing to think about. Okay, so if you made it so far, great work. And just from now on, you can look at this and you can, every time you see a subjunction, you can try to just check it if like the word order is right. And the more you do this, the more natural it becomes as well. So, as always, thank you so much for listening, and see you again soon.